It was a long time since I recorded an episode. It's like creating some art. Like you have to be in that state of mind to could create something. It's like writing a book or do a painting like that. You have to be in that state of mind, and it's nothing you can do to make it happen. It's only coming. And today I am a little into this to recording, but not the best I can be in. But I felt I needed to record something for you that follow me, waiting for an episode. And today is about the asagod. What do you think? It's asagod something real, or is it some like a fairy tale? It's called the myth or a saga. It's the same as asagods and Vikings are almost the same thing. It's go into each other. And I do my family tree on many places, but one is family tree, family search, is the Mormon church family tree research, and it's very strange for many, but I discovered something there. Because my parents that both have branches that lines that is going down far deep into Jesus' time, because they were royals. They were royals in their branches, or else it's ended in 1650. There they started to write in names in the church books. It's where ordinary people can go to. It's 1650. But we that have royals and a noble family, we can go far deeper because it's written up in books. They could write and read in those families, so they write up in their like a family Bible, and they write up all the names. So, and then is it people that have been historical known and talk about them like famous investigator, like that, visionaries, and I have all of them in my family tree because They were together, those people that had much money. And the nobles and royal family didn't allow the people from all families to marry. Only married into the... They must be nobles or royals could marry in the family, royals family, and nobles were wealthy family. They be like cousins. Everyone was cousins. And now when I go back, I'm going back with in my mother's line, and it was going from the Vikings to England and to France, and going, and then it was this tribes called the Franks that was in Rome, Italy, and then they go, the Catholic Church go down to Israel. It's very much I have been in Israel 3 times, and it's huge, big Catholic Church in Israel everywhere, and on the walls on the Catholic Church there is the cross that is about those knights, those that make war in the whole world to make Christianity be the biggest religions. So it has been the same as with the Muslims. It's a mirror of each other. All these Abraham religions have started the same. So I think it's not so strange with Islamic religion, because it's the same have it been in Christianity and the Jewish religion. It's have been the same thinking, how to be the biggest religion. I did a mistake, erase my family tree, and I had to start over. But I had a family tree that was based on my first result of my DNA. I got some names and I placed them there in the tree. So when I started now, I had about 10,000 people in that tree. So I didn't really start from scratch. But I didn't have that line where my mother go down to Jesus. But then I did it. I got that branch back again. But now, suddenly, I saw interesting names coming up in the tree, in her tree, her branch, that was not the same as the branch that go down to the Jesus. So I follow it. I've started in our time and then go back. And then I come to the asagods and the family search organization. They have recorded asagods. I'd be so surprised that they had done it. But it was the same with the Vikings, that they could see who was son and daughters to whom. And many things is not written down in that time because they couldn't. They have these runes that they did it on rocks. Inside the caves there is pictures that show what they did. But it is harder to know their names. But there was kings in the Viking kings that was known. And it's the same as in the Jewish line. It's not written down. It is oral. It's talking about these people from generation to generation. So that's what it is in the Vikings. And then is it with the asagods? And I'm not sure that they are only like a fairy tale. I think there is some truth in it. I don't think that the family search should put their names if there was not really something in it that makes sense. Because when I started, I didn't see it before I come to Odin. And I am from the Nordic countries, and the asagods come from the Nordic countries. So that's in that way, is it not strange? Because I know my ancestor lived in Norway and some on Iceland and Denmark and Sweden. So I know that they were related to these Vikings. So it makes sense. There needs only to be either a father or a mother, and then a child. It need to have a name that is on one parent and one child for the chain to move forward. So when I have done this branch with asagods, sometimes I couldn't go the whole time on the father side, all those kings there was. Sometimes it stopped there. There were no name. After one king, there was not a king. Continue with a king. But instead, I know since I look at the Viking line and the asagods, it's suddenly is a stop. But then I have to go back and look at the children and then find where the connection are. It can be either the mother, but sometimes it have been the son be married to a woman, and that woman's parents I can continue with and go farther into the chain. So it's not that is father to father to father to father, like that in generation. It have to go, because in that, both in the Viking time and the Asagod's time, women was very powerful. They were many times leaders. There were only one queen and no king that lead the area where they live. So it's not like on the side of the clean Christianity that is only men, because there in Viking time and Asagod's time, women was the leaders many times. So I like that, because I don't believe that only man is created by God to be leaders. No, it can't be like that, because God don't see the gender of a person. God doesn't care if it's a woman or a man that is leaders of something, that we are equal in that way. God created Adam and Eve to be equal in their work, the work they should do, but they didn't understood, because they have already started to do the sin. They had sex with each other when God found them nude in Eden. They were already had lust to each other and created babies, and that was not what God was talking about. He didn't create Adam and Eve to make them make lots of babies. What God created Adam and Eve was to work together into the goal God want them to reach. But instead they were talking into sex. The snake took them into sex, so their eyes was open and they saw each other in sexuality. They got lust to each other and created baby instead to work together to reach the goal God wanted them to be. And when God saw it, he go angry and threw them out, cast them out from Eden. And they have to take care of themselves and their offspring. One half of the offspring was not good. It was evil, because the God took away their hand of protection from them, because they didn't do what God wanted them to do. There was people on earth before Adam and Eve, but they have no love in them, and they have no God in them. So that's what God wanted Adam and Eve to do. It was to create children of those that was already born on earth. But they were not God's children, those that was already born before Adam and Eve. So God wanted Adam and Eve to work to make those people that was already born to be the children of God. That's what it means. Have nothing with sexuality to do. Nothing. It have with the spirit to do. spiritual children. Adam and Eve should do spiritual children for God. So I have never been interested of the asagods, but and I don't know very much about them, but I come to Odin, and then I come, he was married to Freya, and then they got their children, and before Odin and his I write up his father and those going down in that line back to the beginning of the humankind, and I stop because I was tired to write it up, so I stop at Abraham, and those asagod was going into Abraham, so everything is coming out from Abraham of these religions. And then I started to understand more what my mother say when she come through, and it's a spirit here now. I feel it very strong. It's hit my solar plexus very much now, so it can be hard to speak. I think that it's my mother that is coming through, because I started to talk about her, that she come through before I knew God, before Jesus Christ was standing in my home and took me on this 21 years journey. And it is September 19, 2021 today. So she come through one night, and I know it was for real, it was not a dream. I was up to upper room, and I know when I am in the upper room, because every time I have been to the upper room, it is dark brown old oak tree wood around in the room. It can be in the stairs and it can be on the walls, but it's always those old oak tree panels. And it looked almost like a hospital, the hall, the corridor hall, but it was very shining, and it was very white around the wall, and on the floor was like a glass, Milky Way, and but far away I saw that it was like a wall of old oak tree in that over from wall to wall, and a door, but the door inside that dark old oak tree wall, that door, it was open, the door, And so I walk closer to that wall, and I saw a person was standing there, but the person was not looking at me. And the closer I come to that person, the more worried that person seems to be, and trying to hide from me. But it was like too late for that person to go into that open door and run away. So it was standing in the corner of the oak tree wall and the white wall that was on the side of the corridor. And then when I come close, it had no way to hide, so this person turned around, and when she turned around, I saw it was my mother. And I didn't know God. I was thinking like most people that not believe in God, and even those that believe in God, or they believe in Jesus, they think that there is nothing after death. Those Christian people that believe in Jesus as God, they think that we are laying in a grave under the ground, laying in the grave and wait for to come up to God. And I know that it isn't like that, but in that time when I saw my mother up in the upper room in heaven, I asked her how is it to be dead. I asked her. So crazy, but I didn't know. And she be not angry, but it's like she was thinking, you are so stupid. You are so stupid. Her face looked like that. She didn't say anything. Instead, she answered me and say that you on earth, you think there is only one God, but we are many, she say. She say this, you on earth think there is only one God, but we are many. I know she don't talk about one God. That was not in her talking. It was she talking about many less powerful gods. Powerful, but less than the only God. God can't be in many places in once. He's sending out what we call angels, and it's what is like these small gods that my mother was talking about. And then when now when I go down and go into asagods, and I have not thinking about them as living people, but I my experience of them since before, it have been that they are coming through and show up for me. So in some way they must live like they maybe live it like an energy. Now my mother is forcing me. She pushed me in some way. I don't know what she's want to talk about yet. She's here. I see her as it is my mother. I recognize her. She's standing here and she have this eggshells color dress on her, like a monk dress. But she is much taller than she was in real. She say, real? She say, once she say to me that from heaven, she say that I was talking to my mother in English, and my mother couldn't speak English, and I say to her, "Oop, I talk to you in English, and you don't understand what I'm talking about." And she laughed at me and she say, "No, I can English," she say, "because in this way of telepathy, there is a universe language, so it changed to be, so she understand English, and they understand every language. Nothing is hidden from them. They know every language. If you have asked, have question about that it's like translating, because it's in the spirit, and it is like a telepathy talking for them. So they understand everything. So she say that to me. So I know it, that it doesn't matter that I speak English. And she couldn't speak. She understand me anyway. So it's so typical, my mother. She's here and she take away dust on my things now. And she look at the, she take a finger and hold it on my television, and it's dust coming on her finger, and she look at the finger, because she was so perfect in everything. Her home was always clean, 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 clean. So she don't like my home because I don't have it. I never got it from her. Or else she took it away, because she always clean up after me. So I never learn from child to be clean. I have never had a home that have been clean. I know where things are most of the time, but I take away dust and these things, but it's going quicker to be dust than what I take it away. That's the problem. I have other things to do than to clean up the whole time. Not like her. I'm very much like my father, very much. So she said that I should tell you. And I don't know what she means with that. It's about this with small gods. She say, I didn't say that. So I ask her to explain what she means when she comes through, because now we have coming closer. I have coming closer to heaven, so I can talk to her better than I did then, because I understand more. And so Mother explained for us how you wanted to tell us about heaven from your side. And yeah, as she said, it's true that I know she is in the center of heaven, and she's working with to bring people to different places in heaven. One time I met an angel, and we were sitting and talking. I was waiting. She and I was waiting for the bus. It was a very old woman, and she said she knew my mother. She said to me, and she said, now I realize something she said that I didn't knew in that time. It was in the late 80s I met this angel, and she said to me that you look that like you are from Israel, she said to me. She said that I look like I come from Israel. And she said that she knew my mother, and where we was sitting and talk, it was about 3-4 hours to drive with a car to that place. She said that she was working with my mother, but today, in that time, I realize now that's what my mother was coming here for me to remember this time. Because when the angel and I was sitting and talking, and she said, you look like you are from Israel, she said to me. And I'd be very surprised, because I didn't know anything about God and the Bible. So I was surprised that she said I was from Israel. And then she said to me that she knew my mother. She had been working with my mother, she said. And I didn't understand. Now today I understand. That's what I was saying to my mother, that I know better today than when I talked to her in that time. It's come true now. That angel, she said she had been working with my mother, and she described my mother not from how she looked like. She described my mother as a very wise woman, she say. She was a very wise woman. And now when I talk about this meeting, I understand what she was saying, because she was saying she was working with my mother, and I didn't understood, because I thought it was in that city far away that they were working together, and Abby's like a question mark. I didn't get it together, these things. But what she was talking about was that they were working up in heaven. She was working with my mother in heaven. And she come down to meet me. And she wanted to tell me about that I was from Israel from the start. That make very sense for me now when I have done my DNA, that on my mother's side I reached down to Jesus. So that's, and it's like I always have, since Jesus Christ come, I have always felt like, and I can see it also, that I go like a parallel to Jesus. I am a woman, a female Jesus. I go exactly the same as him. And it makes sense that she say I was from Israel. If she should be more clear, she should say I was from Palestine. But she said Palestine, I had a new less than it was better for her to say Israel. My mother say here that she was sending this woman down to me. And this woman, I met her 2-3 times later on also. But suddenly one day she was away. And no one knew where she come from, and no one could tell where she moved. She was only gone, and she told me when I was in her home, she told me that she have, she was hit. It was evil people that come to her home and threw rocks into her window, crush it, and she have very, very hard to be there in that place where she lived. It was something with that she was hunted so very, very much. It was like someone wanted her go away because she was too close. She was too close to me. And I should have known maybe everything if I have stayed with her and talked to her. So it was not time for me to know everything, and maybe she should have told me everything, what's from heaven. And I know that she had plans, she said, to open up a school to teach people. She had plans to, she showed me the house where she said she should start open up a school in the information place. But there were enemies to her, so she never come to open up that school. So something was it with her that she had very much contact with heaven and come from heaven also down to meet me. And that's sad. I must ask my mother, is it why you wanted to come here and talk for me to understand this meeting with that woman? I have very much pain in my forehead now. It's very much now going on with spirit things. Is there something you want to tell more, Mother? Is there something more you want me to be reminded of? That it's this night. It was all a very strange meeting. It had nothing with my mother to do, I think. But there was he's 34 years old, 34 years old, 34 years old man that I don't know how he come into my friend list on Facebook, but he have been my friend maybe only 1 month, and then suddenly one day he never talked to me. And he was Jesus' lover. He had not the same God as me. He was Jesus as God. And this night, the last picture he put up on Facebook, where he is in an ambulance. But he didn't say anything why he was in the ambulance. But I had a strange feeling that something was not right. And a deep wrong. Not like he was sick. Of course, when I see the ambulance that he was in, it could be something, but not so serious. Thing, but I felt like it was very serious, and then he didn't write anything on Facebook for 15 days, and I write on his profile post where he is. I can't. No one tell us where you are. If you are okay, I wrote. That have happened before, that people don't say anything. I don't understand why people that knew him don't go worried and ask, where are you? But they didn't do that in 2 weeks, and I have to write and ask, where are you? And then one day a man was writing on his post and say that it seems like he is not here. He have opened up a new account on Facebook. And I was thinking that his profile maybe have been hacked. Someone have taken his profile. And I was waiting, and then suddenly one day a man wrote that he is not writing here, he is on a new account. And I say it's maybe being hacked, or he can't reach this account anymore, I say. But now, this night he died. And a person wrote that he have written to her a very nice mail to her for 2 days ago, and suddenly he's gone. I don't know if it was COVID-19, but it seems like that, as he could write to this woman, and then suddenly he died. Because COVID-19 can do that. It can go very quick to from not be so like have hard to breathe a little. Not so they need to have help, but have hard to breathe, but they can write and be on the computer like that. And suddenly, next day, they are dead. So it can go very quick. I have had people that I know that have going so quick. And now, when I know that he died, and I look at his new account, and I saw that what people he have invited them to his new account, and he have placed those people to his new account because he believed that they were praying for him. And they were close to Jesus, and in that way Jesus should come and heal him. And I'd be offended of it. Not very offended, but offended that I'm thinking about that he didn't invite me to come to his new account. And not he had over 3,000 friends, and he only took the 91 people have he on his new account, that he counted them as be close to God. In his God. And I suppose that he have seen what I have posted. And I always tell people that Jesus is not my God. Jesus is a messenger. He was a messenger. He lived here on earth, and he died from earth. And he's every soul, every spirit is coming back to God, but that person, he died as all people die from earth, and he is not God because God can't die. And so I understand that he didn't took me with him in to prayer for him when he was very sick, and that offended me, but that was his choice, so I am going to let it go. But it's only one day since he died, so it's fresh, and and in the end, maybe tomorrow I have forget it, but just now I am offended that I was not one of them he thought could help him to be healed. And I am a healer. I was created of God to be a healer. I was talking about it today, that about this. They ask on Facebook what gift we have had, got from God. So I say, I got the gift from God to be a healer. And I will tell you before I ended this recording, I will tell you the same story that I wrote to them about get the gift of healing. It was one day I had been shopping and was walking and passed over a park close to my home, and it was a very warm summer day, and when I come, so I should go over the street to my house just before I should go away from the grass in the park, it come a chestnut, you know, from a chestnut tree that you have at Christmas time, this. And it come on the left side of me, on the ground. And I only noticed that. But then it come suddenly one more on the right side of my feet. So I was thinking it's something is going on behind my back. So I turned around and look, and the chest tree was very far away from me. So it was not that those nuts was falling from the tree. So I, when I turned around, I saw a man laying in the grass, and he had a motorbike standing also, and on the side of the motorbike he was laying. So I was thinking maybe he have hurt his laying there because he's wounded. So I went into my home with those things I had bought, and then I took a soda, a cold soda and two glass, and then I go into the park again, and I asked this man if he wanted something to drink, cold to drink. So he sit up and drink, and I say to him that, was it you that threw the chestnuts to me? It's dangerous, it's very hard to get it on me. Think if I have turned around and got it in my eye. And he say, I have not thrown any nuts on you, he say. So when I look at him and I understand that he had not done that, it was something supernatural that happened. So I say to him, do you want me to heal you? And to my surprise, he say, yes. He looks so tough, but tired in some way. I didn't understand why he looked so tired. And then I took his hand and do the healing process. And when I have done that, he said thank you to me. And he said that I was laying in the grass because I didn't know how to say to my parents that I am going down to Assyria, Middle East, to fight, to do the fight for my people, he say. And I didn't know how to tell my parents that I will leave from Sweden and go to Middle East to make war. And when you hold my hand, he say, I felt God. And I felt God didn't want me to go there. I know now that I should not tell my parents. I'm not going to travel to the Middle East and go into the war. He said, you changed my mind. And I saw all this tired body and face he had was gone. So that was God. That was God that threw those chestnut on me, on the side of me. He didn't want to hit me, but he did that for me to turn around and see this man. So that's God's gift for me to do healing. The healing can be in many sort of way. It's the healing for him was healing in his soul, and healing also that he was going down there to Middle East and be killed. And he got a life. And their parents doesn't lost their son. So there is many ways of healing. That was one of the healing I have done. That God have told me to do the healing. Because when he threw the nuts on side of me, that was God to say, go and heal this man. And he was Muslim, and I have done many healing on Muslims because they believe in healing. The Swedish people here, they don't want to have someone laying a hand on them. But I have learned that Muslims believe in healing, and healing from a woman also, not that it have to be a man to lay hand on them. So that I have learned. So it's many things to learn that God want me to understand and want you to understand. So thank you for listening to this episode and listen to my visitors. My mother is she waved with her hand, but she don't wave behind her back. She really wave as we do. We living almost like a queen waving with her hand. So thank you for coming and visit us and make me understand this meeting with the angel. That was what my mother came for. So thank you. God loves you, and I love you too.